Could this mark the return of the man who's been nicknamed Super Mario?
Yeah, it looks like he's destined, Genie, probably to become the next prime minister of Italy. He's 73 years old. Now, why Super Mario? Remember, he used to be the European vice president of Goldman Sachs, first of all, and then a former governor of the Bank of England. But it was while he was, for 8 years, the head of the European Central Bank that he got this nickname, because he made that famous speech back in 2012, the whatever it takes speech, which was to support the Eurozone. Many thought the Eurozone was going to collapse at that period. And since then, since the second quarter of 2013, the Eurozone economy has been growing continuously. So if he does take on the job, the hope is that Mario Draghi, being not a member of any of the main political movements in Italy, may be able to bring together the various factions who've been fighting against each other within the Italian government, that in a bid to avoid elections. That is what the president wants to avoid. It's what the markets want to avoid. They say that Italy cannot afford to hold elections right now. It would put it in a period of limbo while it's right in the middle of fighting the coronavirus pandemic. And the second thing is they want to avoid infighting against other parties. They want Mario Draghi to be a unifying figure, but that's already looking a little bit in jeopardy because the Five Star Movement, which is always standing up for the Italian man in the street, has said it will not back Mario Draghi because it fears that if he does become prime minister, he will introduce a period of hard measures, or a series of hard measures, that will cause a lot of misery for the average citizen in the street.
Philip, if Mario Draghi were to accept this job, he does have a lot of challenges ahead of him.
Well, yes, I mentioned the coronavirus pandemic. Italy was one of the first European countries to be hard hit by the pandemic. It has 89,000 deaths so far. That's the highest total of any country within the European Union. So there is a lot of work to do in Italy to try to stem the spread of coronavirus. The second point is the economic recovery plan that has caused a big fight in Parliament with the resignation of the former Prime Minister Giuseppe Conte last week after Matteo Renzi, another former Prime Minister, withdrew the support of his Viva Italia party. The new Prime Minister will have to try to push forward with that economic recovery plan, which is going to have to engineer a path to boost the economy, which has barely grown in decades. There's a massive debt burden in Italy. And on top of that, due to the pandemic at the moment, the economy is shrinking, down 8.9% in 2020. That's the worst recession since World War II. And if that wasn't enough, there are 420,000 jobs lost in 2020, including 100,000 jobs just in December last year. So a lot of challenges to face the new Prime Minister, Super Mario Draghi, if he were to accept the job. He's meeting with the President this afternoon, who's going to put his name forward. So we'll know pretty quickly whether or not he's going to be the new Prime Minister of Italy. But as I said, a lot waiting for him to do. But already the euro has gained versus the dollar today following the announcement of his possible nomination.
Philip, thank you for that. France 24's Philip Turl there talking about the situation in Italy.